Power to the people. No, power to the person. Turn up the power of the unseen speaker. I am valid. Validity is me. Truth is in the mouth. There is no forethought. The mouth is the point of origin where history begins and it follows its predetermined course. You can call it fate. The shaft of time is an alimentary canal where the anus is the end of history. This is my gift to you, where I give enough of myself that we become twins. The end of class struggle, the end of history, the opposite of apocalypse. It is a joyful finish. No more conflict. You have become me. Forget direct observation. What good is it when you are examining yourself? Have faith in an intestinal intelligence. Gut reactions. Have faith. Listen to the voices. Who cares whose voice it is? Haven't we just declared ourselves equals? If the voice beckons, answer it. It is the voice of authority, otherwise silence reigns. These words rumble within the caverns of your bowel. They don't come from the air. They have a more physical presence. They come up from the earth, are akin to the earthquake. Look at me. Stare down the laundry chute and see me toiling in the basement. I'm the one who services the machines whose hum you feel topside. Coming to you from the caverns. Your feet are rooted in my mud. The message travels up your bones. Does the sky touch you? Does it offer your flesh the comfort of massage? I'm willing to offer you more. I'm willing to offer you more. So very much more. Yeah, this is my gift to you. Beautiful, the peristaltic airwaves. These airwaves emanate from the most primitive musical instrument of the earth, and it being the first horn, it is closest to the simplest schematic of a human being. It is only a tube. An elementary canal. The sound that comes from it can be reduced no more. It is pre and post history simultaneously. Don't doubt me. This is no neo-primitivism. Primitivism has been sustained. It exists always. The neo, that which is born again as a lie, the way Adam and Eve were born again after eating of the tree of knowledge. Yet, doubt breeds faith, and I want you to have faith in me. You must have faith in me, since radio is a medium of lies. The disembodied voice, it appeals only to the ear. Shuts the other senses out. I have been mediated. You have been given a representation of my voice. It comes out of my house, runs down the canal, and empties into your house. I'm afraid you're stuck with the ectral end. Thank you. The difference, the only difference that can be drawn between the two ends of a tube is based on who is positioned at either end. Start and finish are associated with giver and taker. I give, you take. I can say that your house is the mirror of the cave that I am now in, and the words I say resonate there exactly as I say them here. I can say that you are my mirror image. Doesn't the mirror take the image of the author? Without the author, nothing can be given. There would be no taker. It is my gift of this sound that forms you. Look at yourself. In the black mirror of the speaker, I know you can't yet because the speaker is hidden, but you will soon, you will soon, you will soon grab yourself by the anus and turn yourself inside out. Reveal your inner workings. Put that which is most basic out into the light and put the decorative outer wrappings where they belong. They are embarrassments that should be hidden inside. The tube is now laid out on the table for everyone to see. You and I are the opposite sides of the coin which has been split and stretched out to form this tube. Stretch it. Mark it. Stretch it. Mark it. Saggy, I am here and you are there and we are connected by our circularity. Baby, slip the diaphragm in and let's get on with it. Whoa! Whoa! This transmission is live. From me to you is peristaltic. Is composed of circular wave motions, as is the intestines. In my hand is the round shaft, the mic. I'm Mike. My name's Mike. If I unscrew the head and slip out the circular diaphragm, our fun stops. Dead air. I'm back now, and if you took the diaphragm's twin sister, the speaker on your radio, out of its protective enclosure, and punctured it, that would be the end. That would be the end. Please, no. We aren't ready to end this, are we? In fact, it's just beginning. You haven't yet the strength to reveal yourself or to reveal the black disc hidden behind the speaker cabinet. You can't yet face the dark music. The queasy feel vertigo when they stare into the pit. And this black hole falls back away from you. It moves fast. Back. Back, falling back into a dark tunnel. Back, 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 back. And how it strains. Literally, it strains a music, it strains a language, and each little jerk of the speaker, each little convulsion travels down the length of the tube to match perfectly the twitches, the purses of my lips. It goes in waves like dominoes, setting each other in motion, a contraction, a dilation. Squeeze, relax, squeeze, relax. It's coming, it's coming. Push, 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 pushing my gift out into the world. Push, push. You can do it. help me. Push. Push. Here it comes. Help me. Help me. Help yourself. But don't help yourself to too much. I'm only willing to give a certain amount. Shut up! I'll give you something to cry about. I'll give you something to cry about. Is that enough? Is that enough? How about that much? Lost in a wintry, wintry wonderland. A wonderland of snow, or a wonderland of dust, or jiggling things. I'm lost. I'm lost, lost, lost in a wintry fairyland. Maybe a fairyland of jiggling things, or of snow, or of swirling dust, and he laughed, and he laughed till he cried, and his belly, why, his belly shook like a bowl full of jelly, and the head loves a downy pillow, and the bird, why, the bird loves a cozy nest, and the fist, the fist loves a soft belly, the fist, loves a soft belly. It loves a soft belly. It loves a soft belly. Yeah, it's jiggling. It's jiggling. Yeah, it's jiggling. Oh, it's jiggling. This is a jiggle contest of sorts. Hoo-wee! I love the competitive spirit. Laugh. Laugh, laugh, laugh. Show your mastery of the situation. Prove your mastery of your bowels, little man. So you think you've mastered them more than me, do ya? Huh. Fuck you. Laugh at me. I dare you. I'll laugh right back. I'll laugh right back and... We'll trade shits. Laughingly. I hear a voice.
Dee.
I hear a tiny, tiny voice.
Dee.
What is that tiny, tiny voice?
Dee.
Who are you laughing at?
Shark.
Shark.
That's not funny.
Shark.
I don't enjoy castration jokes.
Shark. Shark.
I said that's not funny.
Shark.
How many kinds are gonna tell this joke? Come on, buddy.
Shark.
That's not funny.
Shark.
That's not manly. I said that's not manly.
Feelings.
Explosion from the bottom.
Down in the guano mine, sometimes a natural gunpowder forms in the droppings. Enclosed as they are within the confines of the cave, if the gases are ignited, a terrible explosion occurs. In any enclosed societal structure, no matter what its shape, even a pyramidal one, an explosion at the bottom necessarily has ramifications at the top. Why, an old cartoon comes to mind where a duck posing as a doctor in a hospital becomes trapped in an iron lung. His internal balance is thrown off by the machine, which inflates and deflates him like a balloon. When he escapes from it, his body, which was equally distributed, maintains itself now by sudden shifts of weight. A hand will expand while another part of the body dwindles, and so it goes, moving randomly from one part of the body, one part of the body expanding while another part contracts. The moral implications of this story are exhibited in another story, also concerned with the dangerous buildup of pressure. In this tale, some pig farmers conspire to falsely win a contest by increasing the size and weight of their animal by knocking a cork in its ass. The hog gets fatter and fatter and fatter and fatter, and the farmers are sure of their success, then their dream ends in an explosion and a storm of shit. No, these stories aren't meant as parables in defense of the abolition of upper and lower. For in contrast is dynamics. Anyone who's been to the farm can testify to the importance of a pecking order. Can you imagine a society of equal chickens? In equality, there is the loss of the impetus to act. The birds sit in line and unmoving in monotonous quay. Give me conflict. Give me action. Two-fisted action. As above, so below. The middle exacts the toll. Ring him dry, yes. In pigs, the head and feet are of little worth, but in man, they are of the highest value. The two points with which the line is drawn. In between, no man's land. Feelings.
Feelings.
Glowing angels, pulsing crotches, ecstasy accompanies the act of creation, especially when the canvas is the human body. Sexuality is heightened, a feeling of floating above. I feel divine. The actor, the audience, subjective, objective, audience assumes the god's eye view, far off, distant. Examines the extension of itself on the stage. Actor pictures himself as avatar, floating among golden mists, hogs mating in a mud pit. Are the descending flower petals only a barrage of garbage? Not an insult, far, far from it, watching the display, so taken with the reality of the depiction, they believe they are rewarding the animal performers with their favorite food. What a show! Call the SPCA. Hold on. Whoa there, big fella. How can you abuse something if it's your equal? Men and pigs are on the same level. The line that stretches from my mouth to you is the same as that and pigs as that and all animals. The only difference is that in me the tube is vertical. It points toward heaven, while in pigs, because they travel on all fours, the tube is horizontal. It runs parallel to the dirt. Reestablish your animal nature. Get on all fours. Hey, what are you pigs doing in here? Back off, asshole! Scoot back and butt your ass to the speaker. Feel its tender vibrations at last sign and signified meet. My words travel straight through by the most direct route and circumvent the ear. Your lips vibrate as mine. There's not much lag time, is there?
There's not much lag time.
Hey! Come back. See? Very little lag time. My power, the speed of sound. My voice is almost instantaneously at your door. It arrives faster than you can escape, though my voice is plowing slow, dim-witted. It will reach you no matter how fast you run. Zombies and horror films, how slowly they drag themselves in the frantic pace of the victim. It is the miracle of technology that merges them. But it is finally cut the two pieces of form. The girl and pursuer and pursued me. The victim meets fate. Has my voice caught your ear?
It was faded love at first sight. Oh, doe eyes, big, 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 brown, brown, brown doe eyes. This is for the folks at the Buck and Doe Tavern up in Fawnskin. And condolences on the death of your fawn.
How much wood can a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? How much fly could a horse fly fly if a horse fly could fly horse? How much fawn could a fawn skin if a fawn skin could skin fawn? And how much fawn could a fawn skin if a fawn skin could skin fawn? Oh, doe eyes, oh, rumpled fawn skin, you are disabled. You cannot see me. Yes, the radio is blind. The poster child is cute, but her sad eyes are useless. They elicit no response from the blind. You don't know what you're missing. Now, I'm holding out my hand. I'm offering you the world, but you walk on by. By ignoring my gesture, by ignoring me, you're forcing me to speak, to draw attention to my own generosity. How embarrassing. Yeah, well, cram it. Two can play this game. I'm no fan of the light myself. The mother that loves you will withdraw the tit. Fast! Once the milk tooth comes in, and once baby touches the hot stove, it'll never do it again. Black tooth, chew on some licorice, that's black. Chew on some tar, that's black. Don't chew on bubble gum. That's not black. Don't chew on abalone. That's not black either. In the cave is the lowest foundation. Here lie the irreducible themes. The only white light found here is in the form of a small stunted albino bird, the blind cave pecker, the woody pecker woodpecker, and he too can be run through the prism, the vampire who drains the enclosed color and leaves the thing doubly pale and ritually bled the river of fluids run off into tributaries of primal pigmentation. The family of man is united in these substances. No, I may not live in Harlem, and no, I may not live in Watts, but I eat of the same white bread, the wonder bread, that is bread reduced to its lowest and simplest form, the congealed weed paste. And this is the bleached glue which I sniff for my homogenized and safe glue high. I draw on the same white paper. I'm high on life. And Jonathan Livingston Pecker Woodpecker has landed on the roof of my house. And built a nest made of threads culled from the coat of many colors. Guess who? That's right. Guess who, honky? I've been waiting a long time for this. I've been waiting a long time for this. I've been waiting a long time for this. I've been waiting, waiting. Quit that fucking cackling! Hey, Granny. Take a gander on down that ear trumpet that's dedicated specially from me to you. Set your roomy old eyes deep into the speaker end. The queasy feel vertigo when they stare into the pit. And this black hole falls back away from you. It moves fast, back, back, back into a dark tunnel. Let's switch the headlights off and ram the pedal to the floor. What a thrill ride. Go fast. Go faster. Go faster. Go fast. Go faster. Go faster. Let's switch the headlights off and ram the pedal to the floor. What a thrill ride. No, we don't know. We don't know where we're going. We don't know where we're going. We don't care. We don't care. We know you'll come out at the end somewhere. Spock, warp factor it. Warp factor it. Yeah, we're gonna come out soon. We're gonna come out soon. We might even come out in pieces. When the dust settles, cut it in the lines. This mine's been played out. The heap's been scraped down to the floor. Got an allergy? Let's get dusted. Take a snootful. Wow. What a limb rush. Guano bomb. Bawana don. The great white hunter of saltpeter. Salt peanuts. Salt peanuts. Saltpeter. Saltpeter. Soft penis. Soft penis. Oh. When the dust settles, cut it into lines. Take your end of the tube and blow that powder right back into my head. I am elephant-headed diva. I am elephant boy. I am French girl. My head stretches in the tube, off into trunk. The Hindu gods multiply limbs and sense organs, symbols of their power. So too does my cave break off into tributaries. Go. My voice in every house. My mouth speak in unison. I am my own choir. Yeah. My mouth speak in unison. I am my own choir. Salt peanuts, salt Peter, a chicken in every pot. I'm going to give myself a call. One of my many, many, many selves. Yep. I'm going to give myself a call. One of my many, many selves.
Come to the phone right now, but Please leave your message after the tone.
Hello?
Hello? Is Chicken there?
Yes.
Mr. Chicken, free yourself from the constraints of money. I'm not going to pay for this call.
Okay.
Good. Good, 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 Mr. Chicken. Good, 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 Mr. Chicken. And Mr. Chicken?
Yes?
Your radio's not up loud enough. Beautiful. When my many, many eyes look into each other's pupils, when my many, many mouths kiss each other, when my many, many trunks blow dust up each other, when you and I look into the mirror of each other's face, that sets up a beautiful feedback loop, the pure tone of selfhood compounded. Listen to yourself. Touch yourself. Feel yourself. Go ahead. Gratify yourself. I think you're ready now. Ready to take on the mantle of the magician. To lift the veil that clouds the marvelous. Get out your screwdriver. Remove the sheath from the radio. This black speaker has been sequestered in the convent of plastic or wood or metal for too long. Hidden there. There, like the genitals are hidden under the clothing. Twin brother. Twin sister. Soulmate. I'll take mine off if you take yours off. I'm sure of our pure correspondence. Take your dress off. Take your pants off. Remove the sheath from the speaker. Show yourself the throbbing black disc. As I speak, it quivers. My voice puts it into spasms. It jiggles. It pulses like your genitals are now pulsing. Put your finger to it. Squat over a mirror. Stare into the black hole eye to eye. Its emptiness is your fulfillment and my pleasure. Touch yourself. Feel yourself. Go ahead. Gratify yourself. Soulmate, I absolve you of all guilt.